Now we have a blessing of breath. Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the candles of this breath. May the breath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us begin this Holy Eucharist. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today, Church celebrates first Sunday of Advent. Advent reminds us to prepare ourselves to receive Jesus into our hearts. Let us prepare ourselves to take part in this Holy Eucharist. And ask the pardon and mercy from the Lord. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done,
what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my grievous faults. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, every Virgin, all the angels and saints, to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive our sins and bring us an everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up David for your just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her, the Lord our justice, the word of the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are God, my Savior, and for you I wait all the day. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. All the paths of the Lord are kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and his decrees. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him, and his covenant for their instruction. To
a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts, to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you received from us, how you should conduct yourselves to please God. And as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Us your salvation. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these signs begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that day catch you by surprise like a trap. for that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times, and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today, we begin the liturgical year to the first Sunday of Advent. The liturgical year will have six seasons. They are season of Advent and season of Christmas, season of Lent, season of Easter Triduum, season of Easter, and ordinary time. Today we begin the season of Advent. This season begins 4 Sundays before Christmas and ends with Christmas Eve. The word Advent comes from the Latin word Adventus, which means coming or arrival. The season of Advent has twofold characteristics. First of all, it is a preparation for celebrating the birth of Christ. Secondly, it reminds us of his second coming in glory at the end of times. The first reading is taken from the book of prophet Jeremiah. This passage is a part of book of consolation in the book of Jeremiah. The context of this passage will help us to understand the words of prophet Jeremiah. Most of the kings after the king David, they were corrupt and they did not listen to the voice of prophets. That led them to political suffering and captivation. So people lost their hope. In this context, prophet Jeremiah speaks about a future Messiah who will fulfill the promises of the God that he made to the people of Israel. Jeremiah assures the people and all of us that the Messiah, when he comes, he will bring justice and righteousness. The prophecy of Jeremiah finds its fulfillment with the birth of Jesus in the lineage of King David. In the second reading, St. Paul explains some of the qualities we should have as we wait for the coming of the Lord. He says that we should be blameless before God the Father. He urges everyone to have love for one another so that we will be prepared for the second coming of the Lord. Today's gospel also follows the same theme. St. Luke tells us that the Lord is coming, but watch yourselves that your hearts do not become drowsy. Be vigilant at all the times. Do not become drowsy means that we must watch carefully and do not lose the focus on God. The words of Jesus in the gospel, stand erect and raise your head, means be joyful and give praise. The three readings of today's liturgy speak to us, be vigilant and awake for the Lord. This waiting must be active and joyful. This will be the best preparation for the birth of Jesus. Today we have a beautiful, the Advent wreath. This Advent wreath is a meaningful tradition practiced by many Christians during the season of Advent. The custom is part of the spiritual preparations that believers make for the coming of Jesus Christ at Christmas. The Advent wreath is a circular garland of evergreen branches representing eternity. On that wreath, four candles are typically arranged. Each candle represents an aspect of the spiritual preparation for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The first candle, called the prophecy candle. The prophecy candle lit on the first Sunday of Advent. It reminds us that the faith-filled hope of the prophets who foretold the coming of the Messiah. The second is the Bethlehem candle. It is lit in the second week. It symbolizes the expression of love. The third week, the rose candle is lit. It symbolizes joy. In the fourth week, the angel candle signifies peace on earth. So the season of Advent gives us an opportunity to look at our past life and also look at future with hope. It is a time to deepen our relationship with God and His beloved Son, Jesus. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made,
consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things are made, for us men and for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sins,
He was crucified and despised,
suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again to judge the living and
the dead. His kingdom will have. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, that proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord of the Lord. And has spoken to the prophets. I believe in the Holy God, and that's all the church. I confess my baptism
for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and life of the world to come.
As we enter this holy season of Advent, we prepare our hearts to receive the Messiah with joyful hope. Let us offer our praise to the Lord.
For an increase in religious vocations, may the Lord bless those discerning priesthood or consecrated life with generous and open hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, you are upright.
For a world that will raise up servants who protect the vulnerable, especially the aged and the unborn, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, you are upright.
For those who struggle with questions about their faith, may the power of God's grace bring them peace and understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, you are upright.
For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit help us increase and abound in love for one another as children of our Heavenly Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died in Christ, especially Lucille Silva and all the intentions for the souls of the faithfully departed, at the foot of our altar. May they live in glory forever with God and all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Loving Father, please hear and answer our prayers this day in your wisdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Joseph took his wife and her child, and they went to Africa to escape the rage of a deadly king. There along the banks of the Nile, Jesus listened to the song that the captive children
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Lord, accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all the church. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the loneliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis un celi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed, and he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and our Bishop Myron Cotta and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heir to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, and we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not temptation, but deliver us from every evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be.
Until the Son of God.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray, for even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We have very few announcements. Attention, parish ministry and organization leaders. Please contact Mary Ferrier in the parish office to schedule an appointment for the facility use and COVID protocols. We are excited to have you back on church grounds. Prepare for Christmas by celebrating the Sacrament of Reconciliation. Our Advent Penance Service will be offered this Wednesday, December 1st at 7 p.m. here at St. Anthony's Church. Please consult the parish website for additional local penance services. There will be no confession next Saturday at 8 a.m., December 5th. We are collecting gift cards and small gift bags for our annual giving tree. Gift cards may be purchased from St. Anthony's School, which will additionally benefit our school. They can be dropped up in the mail slot at the parish office any time prior to December 17th. No live teen and age this week. Please join us again next week on December 5th and 6th. See St. Anthony's website for full holiday schedule. St. Anthony's CYO is looking for voluntary volleyball coaches for 3rd, 7th and 8th grade teams. Email Billy Estrada to get your paperwork started. Volleyball registration is now open. Registration form is available at the school office. Last day to register is February 1st. Thank you. Now, our deacon has something to share with you about baby shower.
Next weekend, we'll be having our annual baby shower for Jesus at all masses. All gifts go to the Pregnancy Help Center of Manteca to help new mothers and their infants. Please bring your gift for baby Jesus to Mass with you next week. We will be collecting them during Mass. Monetary donations and gift cards from Target, Amazon, Costco, and Walmart are most helpful. If writing a check, please make your check out to the Manteca Pregnancy Help Center. If you prefer not to give money or gift cards, there are certain items that the Help Center is in need of. Baby care items that are needed are thermometers, diaper rash cream, nail clippers, brush and combs, medicine droppers, and nasal aspirators. Baby clothes needed are 0 to 3 months onesies, sleepers, and outfits, 9 months through 24 months / 2T, onesies, shirts, pants, sleepers, and outfits. Now, I don't expect you to remember all those, but at the bulletin boards at every exit are little flyers, and at the lower, smaller print, there is this list available to look at. The items that the Help Center has an overabundance of and are asking people not to bring, again, this is things that they're asking people not to bring, are blankets, diapers sizes newborn 1 and 2, and baby knickknacks like picture frames, crosses, baby figurines, and nursery decorations. They have a finite amount of space, so they need to be somewhat careful with regards to what it is that they take. On behalf of Manteca's Pregnancy Help Center and myself, I want to thank you for your thoughtful consideration.
Let us stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.